Hey there. I'm so glad you could join me today for a story. This one takes place after the flood. If you haven't heard that one yet, if you want to, go back and listen to it. It's wonderful. Today's story shows what happens when God tells us to do something, and instead of doing it, we do something for ourselves. It's also about pride. Pride is when we think we're better than someone else. God hates pride. When we think we're better than someone else, we start to think that we don't need God or anyone else anymore. Pride comes before the fall. We're always going to need God. Don't turn away from Him. Have you ever heard someone tell someone else not to be a Nimrod? Where that comes from is this story I'm about to tell you. So God told Noah and his family, after the flood was over, to go and multiply and spread all over the earth. Well, everyone wanted to just stay together in one place. They slowly moved eastward over the years to the land they called Shinar. I don't know if that's Shinar or Shinar. But Noah's great-grandson was named Nimrod, and he was king over this land. Nimrod persuaded the people to stray away from God and to believe it was his leadership and their own courage that made that happiness possible. Well, since it hadn't been that long since God had flooded the earth, everyone on earth spoke the same language. Since Noah, they had passed it down through the generations. Since everybody spoke the same language, they could work together pretty good. Well, Nimrod saw this as an opportunity. He figured that if God had the mind to ever flood the earth again, that he wasn't about to be caught up in it, and he would also avenge his ancestors that God had destroyed. Since he'd made everyone so dependent on him, they were all ready to follow him on just about anything he wanted to do. He convinced everyone in that land that if they built a tower up to heaven so high that the floodwaters couldn't reach the top, that they could keep themselves safe from another flood and make a name for themselves. So they built themselves a city, and the work began on the tower. Day and night they worked making bricks for the tower. They would hold the bricks together with tar, that way the water wouldn't be able to get in. The lower parts were very thick and strong. The people did really good and hard work because Nimrod assured them that they would make a name for themselves. There were so many working on the tower that it grew very high very fast. Since they was using bricks instead of stone, time was saved because they could bake the bricks a lot faster than cutting blocks of stone out of solid pieces. So Nimrod convinced everyone that since they could all speak the same language and work so well together, they would be known all over the world for generations as the ones who built the world's strongest and tallest tower. Again, pride comes before the fall. So one day, God decided to come down to earth. He just wanted to step into his creation and see what was going on. So he noticed that a lot of everyone's attention had been taken away from him. Of course, he knew that they were building a tower. He knows everything. But when God saw that they were acting crazy, working around the clock just because one man inspired them to do so, he got very disappointed. He could see that humans didn't learn their lesson from the flood. But he had a pact with Noah. He couldn't destroy the earth again with a flood. God knew if he let them continue building that tower, that their pride would only grow and they would eventually turn completely away from him. And soon it would be just like before the flood. There wouldn't be any good left anywhere. God told Jesus that if these people could do this from just being able to speak the same language, then nothing they planned to do would be impossible. So he grabbed Jesus and came down to earth and mixed up everyone's languages so they couldn't talk to each other. Then he took the different language groups and placed them all over the earth, like he had told Noah and his family to do in the first place. This was the beginning of all the different languages we now have on earth. It makes sense because if this had not happened, wouldn't we all still be speaking the same language that Noah had taught his descendants? Things like this are what happens to us when we don't listen to God, when we don't want to follow his instructions. One of the hardest words in the English language for me to understand is the word obey. It seems like I have such a hard time doing that. So anyways, after God scattered them all to the corners of the earth, the work on the city and the tower stopped. The city was called Babel because it sounded like the Hebrew word for confusion. To this day, we say someone is babbling when we can't understand what they're saying. This story shows just how much the people could have done for God if they would have put as much work in doing amazing things for him that they put in building the city and the Tower of Babel. But instead, they chose pride over God, just so people would call them great. Jesus taught that we need to change and become like little children, humbling ourselves before we could ever enter the kingdom of heaven. He said that the humblest among us would be the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Everyone is special. You are special. God made you that way for a reason, whether to do works for him or to help others in their works. Although we can't get to heaven by our works, we have to have faith in Jesus. We have to acknowledge him as the one who saved us. He made you the way he wanted to make you. There are no mistakes. You are not a mistake. We all have something special and are here for a reason. That reason is not to build a tower to make ourselves look good. Love God and love others. Them's the rules. If you're listening to the podcast, please share it on your social media. Or if you're watching the video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell so you'll get notified when I post a new story. I enjoy being with you so much. Please leave a comment. Let me know how you liked it. I love you, and God bless.